Welcome my name is Casey.
Sit here.
Mike, good to meet you, Mike. Just driving their 2020 GT with Lando Norris. So the GT, which one is that?
This is a GT, but this is the 570 GT.
So, I don't think it's as fast as the...
I won't be, mine's tuned as well, so, but no, I...
But it's sexy, and yeah. This is like a daily driver.
What's good, guys? I'm here at Golds. It's been a while, man. Been a while at Golds, man. Like that, I've actually filmed here as I've been filming in Self Made. And but today I'm here with Big Mike.
Yo, what's happening?
Guys, today we're gonna smash some arms and give you guys some tips. Today's a more relaxed session, like so we're just gonna chill out, maybe chat a bit, and yeah, get a good arm session in, man. So let's do it. Guys. Those of you that haven't seen me like train arms in a while, I'll just give, and for some of you that are new followers, with my arms training, pretty much with all my training, I like to warm up with many sets before doing the heavy sets. So with that, I'm probably doing rep ranges of starting at 20, 15, 12, and then we'll work our way to like rep ranges of 6 and stay at 6 for as many sets as I get comfortable reps, and then do one cool down set before moving on. So I do quite a few sets. It can be sometimes maybe 6 to 8 sets.
Hey, yeah, it ain't nothing like a crispy new pair of shoes.
100%.
You know what I mean? 100%. It's a thing.
Do you ever get this? Because this pisses me off. I buy it.
Uh-huh.
I plan to rock it. When it comes to rocking it, I'm like, you know what?
Yeah, you can't pull it off.
Yeah,
I done it.
And I'm like, oh shit, I got a fresh pair of kicks. And it's been like, you know, I don't know what the return policy is, whether it's like 30 days.
But Nike is good.
But it's passing.
Nike, they're good.
Oh snap, you're good.
See what we're doing? We've worked our way down to the slack now. And providing they're good reps, I'm going to continue at this weight for maybe 2 or 3 sets and then move on.
Typically, you have a shorter rope, and you get that
resistance.
You have leverage right here, but we don't got leverage. It's all grip strength, which is good. You want legit grip strength.
Thank you.
perhaps do this in the end because it's somewhat like assisted?
Yeah, I mean, honestly speaking, my last few weeks of my last few weeks of arms workouts have been like the same. So today I'm actually switching it up. So typically I wouldn't do this like as my first bicep exercise, but yeah, I did fancy a change, man. So that's why I'm doing it today. But it's a great exercise, isolation, of course, you know, so yeah. The way we're gonna do it, we're about to do a drop set, but what we're actually gonna do is, because we want a little bit of a nice drop, so this is, you have to judge your drops. When you're choosing the weights between your drops, you have to think about the rep ranges you're gonna do. So I know that this first one is gonna be real heavy. So what I wanna do is, I want a bigger drop. So I'm gonna put this one over here, and I get a bigger drop from the first one of my drops.
It's not gonna help.
All right, Will.
It's still gonna suck.
It will. I know going from this weight down a whole plate is gonna feel a lot better than if it was just that little 25 pound, but
it's all gonna suck.
It's all gonna suck. All right.
How many?
Failure set.
All right.
Failure set, guys, for those of you that don't know, a failure set is you just keep going until you can't do anymore. You can cheat on your form, but obviously keeping it safe. So let's see how it goes. Double digits. Yep. Alternating. Up.
That drop set was just to wake us up, man. Now we're awake. We're just gonna do one more heavy, one lighter one, and then we're gonna move on. But yeah, I love that. That's a, if you just wanna intensify your training session, add a drop set or add a superset, and bam, the intensity is up, just like that.
I'm talking about since Metroflex days.
Oh, okay.
That long.
Why do you avoid it, Mike? Is it like...
It's not proper? I felt a lot of pain for my bicep, like all in here. Because CT and Rob, they're bigger than me, like physically bigger guys, right? And I'm doing everything they was doing. I think I kind of hurt some of my joints. So I just stopped, you know? But I do stuff, but never like this, you know what I'm saying? But back in the day, we used to. But it would be with barbells and shit,
right.
Crazy shit.
And it goes to show you as well that like some people don't have an arms day. Some people mix it with like chest and back.
That's me.
You know, so, but you can obviously see that we both got big arms, big strong arms.
But
so
you clearly have bigger arms than me because you train, you have arm day.
It's true.
You know what I mean?
It's true, but then mine also is that, but it's the fact that when I started, that's all I did. Arms all day. That's all I knew. I had dumbbells at home. Yeah. I'll do curls and do dips.
See, so and my thing was chest.
Chest. Well, you know, go watch us on chest and you'll see who's the strongest on chest. So it says a lot.
But nah, but whenever, it's wherever, it's going to show where you put focus at is what's going on. You know?
100%.
But trust me, by summertime, people are going to be...
But now we both smash legs. Now that's something we both smash.
And that wasn't my thing in the beginning.
Yeah, no, neither mine.
That was, I was a late bloomer. Yeah. I love it. I love it.
And I love it to death, man.
Can you talk me through this exercise? Like, why do you like this?
Yeah, it's a real simple movement that you get a lot of bang for your buck in. So it keeps you right, nice and tight. It's a real simple extension, and the pump is real. And if you can look at it, you see all triceps, the entire tricep is engaged, even under here. The majority of your tricep is back here, here and here. This is the third part right here, with the power coming back here. But y'all can see how much it's engaged. It's just an easy movement that you get so much out of. I love it. This kind of stuff right here, it helps your bench press. It helps your power, okay? Because the driving force for a press is your triceps. The stronger your triceps are, the stronger your pressing is going to be. So.
I'm gonna be honest, I don't know like the number, like I'm gonna pick something silly. It's silly today because of the pump. and I would normally do this as my first bicep exercise when I got all the strength, but I'm gonna try it now and see how we go. But yeah, let's see. So I'm about to train my shoulder, I mean arms. Yeah, buddy. All right, well, I'm about to perform the deadlift and curls.
Don't let Mike fool you anyway. I see you,
hammer. Nah, not this.
There you go.
Not so easy, man.
But listen, you know what? It's a perfect time to discuss something. Now, certain people would watch both of our sets and say, what's the point of doing a weight that heavy and not doing it perfect? See, the thing is, I want to get this right. If we don't do this, then we could never do, let's say something like a 75 or something.
Let's say 70 is our max doing this.
Yeah.
We'll never get past that
if we don't touch
cheat.
That. And a lot of you guys that say that, that's where you might be, like, you can do what you like, to be fair, I don't really care, but you might be missing out on extra strength because you're scared to, you know, give a little leeway with the form on an extra heavy set. Like, no one's trying to claim that was the perfect set with that kind of weight. But I know for a fact, if I do that, then the weights just below it will become that much easier because, you know, my body's trying to adapt to that heavier weight, meaning this one's gonna be easy. It's a simple logic, you know?
So, it's just a tactic, and nonetheless, no, it's not perfect, but we're still getting that work.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
We're still getting that work. I've seen people criticize people like Branch Warren and Johnny Jackson on their leg press, short strokes. Look how big they are, that heavy fucking weight. It may not be perfect form to your standards or likings, but there is no perfect form, it's a machine. Or a curl, it's not a competition, right? If we were in a powerlifting competition, that's completely different, right? But we're bodybuilding, we're getting big, right? We're doing what we need to do to get to the games without hurting ourselves. So that's what y'all gotta think.
Without hurting ourselves, that's an important thing there. All right, there's no injuries here, man. So all you guys talking about Snap City or whatever silly things you say, there's no injuries here, man. I've been training 19 years injury free. So what are you saying? You've probably been training like, I don't know, 2 years, you injured yourself twice, three times. And then you're coming to tell someone like me who's been in the game for longer than you've been alive, probably, about how to train. You
know? We don't come into this thinking, oh, I don't want to hurt myself. Yeah. We clearly don't want to hurt ourselves, but we want to come in and get big. Come in and put in some work. Yeah. Move some impressive weight around, and that's what we're doing. There's another, Flex Lewis showed me this. We're doing delt raises, right? He was like, bro, grab the heaviest ones that you could barely move and do these. Yeah. I was like, bro, that looks stupid. I ain't doing that. He said, try it. I got the fucking biggest pump.
I can imagine.
Just this, right? I got my full rest with the lighter weight, but then I went and grabbed some heavy ones.
Yeah.
That's a part of my shit now.
Yeah, 100%, 100%. You know? And it will play into
everything else.
Yeah.
These girls right here.
Guys, we just switched it up. We're gonna finish up with something clean. So we've done all our heavy stuff, to be honest. So we're gonna finish up with something clean. We're gonna do concentration curls on the, preacher curls. That's the correct term. Preacher curl on a bench. So you guys will have seen us do preacher curls sitting on the bench, different angles. This one here, you're gonna get a lot more range because the arm's gonna go all the way like this. It's gonna be slow and controlled.
Thank you.
just like that, it's a wrap. We out. I don't know where you gotta go, but you gotta get the fuck up out of here.
Peace. Done. Over.